Today we're going to move along a little further with our Odroid H3 Plus project. We've now mounted the Odroid onto a MakerBeam frame with the fan mounted at the back. I've adjusted the positioning of the fan to have the fan a little lower so it can handle the airflow beneath the board. We have now added the memory and the storage to our Odroid. Here you can see the two SODIMM memory cards. Each of these memory cards is 16 gigabytes. This will give us a total on the Odroid of 32 gigabytes, which will answer the question, can this processor handle more than 16 gigabytes of memory? We've also added a 1 terabyte SSD. So with this in place, this is going to mount into our frame. And I have already prepared the front fascia. This will fit at the front of the unit to allow access to the ports on the Odroid. I've already added the Odroid switch. The Odroid power switch comes pre-configured and wired with all the necessary cables to plug into the GPIO connector at the side. The battery for the real-time clock has been hot glued to the side of the audio stack. So what we're going to do now is we're going to power up the Odroid to see if it can handle the 32 gigabytes of memory, and also to test just how much power does this actually draw. And here we are ready to power on the Odroid H3 Plus. At the moment, as you can see from the power indicator, we're currently drawing 0.7 of a watt in idle. The power is connected to the Odroid, but we're not actually switched on yet. So let's power up the Odroid and see what our power goes up to. There, our fan is now spinning, we're booting into the BIOS, and we're currently hovering around 14.5 watts. So we'll keep an eye on our power while we go through the BIOS. We can see from the BIOS that our processor is a Jasper Lake, Intel Pentium, running currently at 2 GHz. So we scroll down, we can see we have 4 cores, and it's showing a total memory of 32 gigabytes. So we have proved right away that this particular processor can indeed handle more than 16 gigabytes. So if we move on to the Advanced tab and pick the NVMe configuration, it has also identified that we have a Samsung 1 terabyte SSD installed. And our power has not risen above 14 watts. Admittedly, this is only running the BIOS, but it's a good test to see what the machine can actually draw in power. What we will do in the next video is we will get this unit bolted into the frame, and we'll get Windows installed on it, and we'll try some good performance tests. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching.